Hi guys, Aris, Hardware Busters. A while ago I bought this. This is the CT3 synth load. What it does, it loads USB power adapters like this one or this one. So I want to try it out to show this tool to you, which looks very interesting, and we will go step by step to see how it works and operates. Okay, first things first, you have to take a look at the manual. What a name, AVHZY CT3 USB multimeter. Okay, so this is the manual. Okay, you can control it either through the device itself or through software. I prefer software, of course, it's less complicated. It has lots of options, even cable resistance check, to check your USB cables if they are good for high power applications or not. That's very good, and the software looks good too, but we'll talk about that later. Okay, this is the manual for the PC software. Yeah, it also has a manual for the PC software, from where you can download all this stuff. Google Drive. I will provide the link. Do you use it only as a multimeter? But you can also get the combo with a loader, with a small loader which can load any USB adapter up to 100 watt. This is what I got. The price, $130. Okay, that's not cheap, but believe me, it offers a lot. So let's take a look from the start. I have this power adapter on the tester, Blitzwolf. It has a type C port, so I used an adapter because I couldn't find actually a type C to type C cable here. Let's start with the software. Okay, so as you can see, the loader is already connected, port 3. I named it loader. Okay, status idle, double click on this and we are connected. The first screen, basic, I have already the power adapter on the mains, so you can see the output volt, 5 volt. This is the current, close to zero, okay? And this is the power that it outputs. Maximum and minimum values are here. You see, voltage, output current, output power. You hit create new and start. It doesn't show anything, right? Yes, because look here, you say that it should start logging when current is above 500 milliamperes and stop when it's below 100 milliamperes. If I wanted to start from the beginning, and here we are. The only thing that I don't like so far is that I cannot set the minimum. So as you can see, it's sky high, the graph, so it's not very usable for me. Anyway, I will leave these values, 500 and 100, create new and start. The next thing we want to do is enable the QC3 protocol and ramp up the voltage. I applied 20 volts, but my adapter only went up to 12. Okay. This is supposed to be, it should deliver up to 3 amps on 12 volt, this adapter. So I'm gonna load it up to 35 watt. Module. Here is where you apply the load. This is the page, the tab for the loader. I have set constant current. It has also constant power and ramp up mode where it increases automatically the load on two predefined levels. You can also set the slope and the cutoff. Yeah, that's interesting. So constant current mode, 3 amps. Core temperature. There's also another probe, temperature probe. I haven't installed it because it was on my way. You can see the capability of the loader from 2.5 volts up to 26 volt. The current and the power. 100 watt is a lot for any power adapter. So here is where we will check the ripple. Very, very important. Besides load regulation, ripple is probably even more important. So start. Now I apply 3 amps of load. The cooling fan on the loader has already started. You can see now load regulation. It's okay. 11.93. Output current, 3 amps. 3.001 actually they have said. Power, 36 watt. And let's check on the ripple here. Wow, yeah. It's not that bad. I have tested another power adapter before that and ripple was much higher. 65 millivolt up to 70 millivolt ripple. Frequency of the ripple, 70 kilohertz. You can adjust these things here if you want. The slider. But I want as fast as possible. Sample depth. Let's take a look here. It's very, very advanced, this program. Wow. It even supports Lua scripts. Yeah. You can write your own scripts, your own Lua scripts, and run them. Okay. It's a little bit complicated, but it offers very much. Let's change my window here. Okay. Yes, I'm impressed so far. So, let's take a look at maximum minimum. Yep. Let's create a new, now that I've started the loading process. And here we can see load regulation. Yes, my loader is at 55 degrees Celsius. You cannot call it bad, the load regulation. Ripple, yeah, it's okay. As long as it is below 100 millivolt for a power adapter, I can say that it's okay. I want to increase a little bit more. Yeah, I know I'm risking it since I'm already at 3 amps that this power adapter supports, but cannot help it. So let's try and increase it a little bit more. Okay, power adapter stop. We hit OCP, overcurrent protection. Going back again. Now let's watch ripple how it increases. You see ripple increasing as I increase the load, and the fan of the loader starts to ramp up. And it stabilizes here a bit. Okay, let's go up to 3.1 amps. Okay, peak to peak. Where is peak to peak ripple? Why it doesn't have peak to peak here? Peak to peak, I mean maximum. It would be nice if it had something like that, maximum and minimum values. take a look at the maximum ripple, but it doesn't have it. I don't know why. Back here, you see the minimum is almost zero because the power adapter actually stopped. Create new. Let's leave it a little bit there. Very, very interesting tool. I'm gonna test lots of power adapters because we find cheap power adapters. We connect them to our phones, to even to our laptops, to every device that we can think of, but we don't know anything about their performance. It is very, very important to know the performance of a power adapter, because if it is a shitty one, it can even blow up your phone's battery if you have a Samsung. But anyway, you get a very expensive phone, you pay even thousands of dollars to get a very expensive phone, and you buy a cheap adapter, because the current trend is that they don't provide power adapters with the phones anymore. So if you don't have one, okay, most of us have power adapters, but say that you don't have one, you just buy the first adapter that you will see, and the results maybe not be so good for your phone and your phone's battery as well. Increased ripple isn't good for charging your phone's battery, and it increases temperatures as well. And heat and batteries don't go along, as we all know. So about how long? I'm surely over 1 minute at 37 watt. Okay, load regulation. Okay, not so huge drop. The load is super steady, as you can see. Power, yeah, power 2 and 57 degrees Celsius, my loader. Okay, let's check now another power adapter. Okay, I connected now this power adapter, Blitzwolf PWS6. Let's take a more look at the specifications. QC3. 30 watt. Okay, so I won't go over 30 watts. And up to 12 volt with 200 millivolt dynamic regulation. Standard fast is up to 2.4 amps. Okay, we will check about that and see how it goes. It's already connected. Create new. Five volt output. Okay, almost zero amps and watts. I want to enable the QC3 protocol. You can see here. No, this is the scope. Okay. So, running. Smooth regulation support 2, level regulation support faults, high limit faults, smooth regulation 0. Okay, let's check 12 volt. I wonder why it doesn't go up. Yes, this one didn't couldn't go up to 20 volt. Okay, so start, check the ripple. I see some spikes here, don't like them, very high spikes. Okay, let's start slow. Constant current mode again. Yeah. You can see the spikes, right? Yes, this doesn't look promising, right? 94 at some point, I show. Yes, at light loads, 90 volts. Compared to the other Blitzwolf that we tested before, it's almost double the ripple. Over 100. Oh, wow. 160 millivolt. Oh, damn. Oh, fuck. This is too high. Yes, I will never use this power adapter. 160. What the hell, man? This is a complete shitty adapter. Either it is used, I don't know. I have. Imagine I have another similar adapter and I charge my phone. Probably I must stop doing that. Oh, damn. Let's check here. 10 volts. We drop to 10 volts. And 21 watt. Okay. Let's push it a little more. This is the cutoff. Cutoff means it stops sinking load off if voltage drops to 2.5 volt to protect the loader and the adapter. Twenty-one watt. Okay, it keeps dropping. We bus. Let's go to 2.4, which is what it supports. 2.4 amps. Oh, wow. Yes, a ripple is all over the place. It's way too high. You don't want to charge your phone or any other device with this power adapter. Very high ripple. This is why you should invest on good and quality power adapters. How you can be sure about your power adapter? Check our reviews. From now on, I will review lots of power adapters to check out ripple, load regulation and stuff like that. Although load regulation is a little bit tough with the QC that adjust voltage according to the load, but ripple, yeah, ripple is the most important stuff here. Wow, 150 millivolt. I wonder how come this thing still works and didn't explode in my face, and I have it on my desk. Damn it. I think there's no point in continuing the test with this power adapter. It's a shitty one, that's for sure. So I'm gonna stop the load. Okay. I will put all links into this video's description. I will also have a link for you that wants to get this toy. It isn't expensive, 130 bucks is nothing. If you want to get it, please buy it through the link that I will provide. It's an affiliate link. It doesn't cost you anything more, but it helps me buy more stuff to show, to review in the channel. We have a Patreon page if you want to support us, and hope you like the video. If you have any questions, and if I have any time, I will try to answer them. To reply. Till the next video. Bye bye.